Good day to everyone. Today we will discuss how to wire a control circuit of a three-phase motor to run it on both ways, forward and reverse directions. Further, we need to make sure reverse contactor will be locked while forward contactor is in operation. Likewise, forward contactor should be locked while motor is running on the reverse direction. To start with, we need a three-phase motor, and is shown at bottom right corner. We need a three-pole breaker to supply or break the three-phase power to the motor. Also need a magnetic contactor to run the motor on forward direction. Then, need the second magnetic contactor to run the motor on reverse direction. Further, we need a thermal overload for the motor, and can be fitted to one of the contactors, making sure that it is operational with both contactors. One push button switch is for forward running and one indicator lamp is for indicating it. Need another push button switch for reverse running of the motor, and also the indicator lamp for it. We need a stop push button to stop the motor, and is a normally closed switch, unlike the normally open push button switches used for starting of the motor. Another indicator lamp is needed with amber color to show the motor is tripped off due to a fault of it through the thermal overload operation. Finally, one MCB to supply 230 volts to the control circuit of this motor. Let's take 400 volts three-phase supply through the breaker to the forward run contactor first. From T1, T2, T3 terminals of the thermal overload relay, take the supply to the three-phase motor like this. Now, if you supply power to the forward contactor operating coil by some means, motor will start to rotate, and is on the clockwise direction here. You know, by interchanging any two wires, of the three wires on a three-phase line, rotation of the connected motor can be changed. On a three-phase supply, three individual phases are 120 degrees apart from each other, and as soon as two wires are changed, rotating magnetic field will change its direction. Therefore the rotor of the motor, which follows the rotating magnetic field, will too change its direction. Let's connect the three-phase line to reverse contactor, and need to take the lines out from its bottom terminals like this. We use only one thermal overload for both contactors, and we'll move it down like this, to see the red, yellow, blue lines clearly. Let's connect the red line out from the reverse contactor to the red line out from the forward contactor first. Wires on other two points need to be interchanged here. So we connect yellow line out of reverse contactor to the blue line out of forward contactor. Likewise, blue line will be connected to the yellow line here, making the necessary change needed for reverse running of the motor. So, we move the thermal overload back to its normal position. Now, if you supply control power to the reverse contactor, motor will run on the reverse direction, that is on anti-clockwise direction. Considering 230 volts supply to the control power circuit, you can use any highlighted places here, and take the line through the MCB, to the terminal 95 of the thermal overload relay. 95 and 96 are normally closed points, and we can use them to break the control power, since these points will open the circuit, if motor is at fault. Then from 96, line goes through the normally closed stop push button, to the forward start push button, and to the reverse start push button. Other end of the forward start switch, need to be connected first, to the top point of the normally open auxiliary contact points, on the forward run contactor. This is done, since we need this normally open points later, to hold the contractor points together, when start push button is released. After touching this point, line is connected, to the bottom point of the normally closed, auxiliary contact point, on the reverse run contactor. From top point of this normally closed contact points, a one coil end of forward run contactor gets power. This is to make sure that the power to the forward run contactor is supplied only when reverse run contactor is at off position. This is called interlocking of magnetic contactors, and is a safety measure taken to avoid both contactors getting power at the same time. Now, a two coil end need to be connected to the neutral line. Let's press the forward start push button, and you will see the pathway of control line to run the motor on clockwise direction. There's one issue here. As soon as you release the pressed push button back, contactor operating power line is interrupted, making motor to stop. To avoid this happening, you need the contactor holding bypass connection here, like this. Let's press the forward push button again. When you release the push button back, power line on right side is interrupted, but A1 receives control power through the bypass line now. You can see, normally open auxiliary points on forward contactor, is closed now, enabling power to pass through it. If you want to stop the motor now, press the stop push button once, and release it. Let's wire this for reverse running now. Line is taken from reverse push button, to the top point of normally open auxiliary contact points, on the reverse run contactor. After touching that point, it will go to the bottom point, of the normally closed contact points, on the forward run contactor. From the top point of it, line will be connected to the A1 of reverse run contactor. A2 of it, to be connected to the neutral line. Reverse contactor holding bypass line 2, need to be connected like this, to the bottom of the, normally open auxiliary contact points. Now let's push and release the reverse start push button. You will see, the control power path, is through the bypass line now. Push button switch here, supports control power to the contactor, only till its bypass line, starts holding its contact points together. Now if you want to stop the motor, press the stop push button once and release it. Let's do the indicator lamp wiring now. You know, as long as A1 of forward run contactor, receives power, motor runs on forward direction. So, we take connection from A1 here, to the forward indicator lamp. When neutral line is connected, indicator lamp lights up like this, to show, motor is running on forward direction. Likewise, A1 of reverse contactor, need to be connected to the reverse indicator lamp. When neutral line 2 is connected, lamp will light up to show that, the motor is running on reverse direction. If the motor trips off, you know that, normally close 95-96 points on thermal overload relay, are open now, stopping control power to the contactors. At the same time, normally open 97-98 points are closed now. So, we can use these auxiliary contact points to operate trip indicator lamp. Control power is available up to the point 95. Let's connect 95 to 97 first. From 98, connect the line to trip indicator lamp. When neutral line is also connected, trip indicator lamp will light up like this, showing that the motor has tripped off. Hope you got fair idea now, how to wire the control circuit of forward reverse starter. If you think that this video is helpful, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.